idea.
Thank you.
Oh, I can't wait. Oh, excellent. Substantial field testing, precise reports, and such dedication. What more could I ask for in a research assistant? So, how did my chemical repellent work? Safe and clean like a charm, I'll bet. Those poor little mole ratties. Oh, I wonder if I could make a hypoallergenic version. Oh, but that'd hardly be effective. I should mention that. Proper handling of mole rats could be important if they could be domesticated. Milked, maybe? Oh, anyway, keep the repellent. Oh, but for your trouble, here, have the leftover chems from working on the repellent. I'm sure you can find some use for them. Yes, knowing more about them can help people learn to avoid or even outsmart them. So I picked up this observer device to study them in their natural habitat. I need you to hide one in one of the spawning pods in their lairs. That's great. I recommend the nest at the Anchorage War Memorial. I knew a trader who talked about the Mirelurks down there. Just go inside and find one of their spawning pods, probably down near the water. Put this observer inside and get out quietly. And be sure not to kill any Mirelurks inside their nest. If you do, it could ruin the validity of the study. So, are they intelligent? There's only one way. Good hunting!
So...
I'll bet most people would have just gone in there, guns blazing, without half a thought. But not you. You're the best research assistant ever.
I've been getting a good signal, but what do you think about them from your first-hand observations of them? Oh, really? Maybe their leader figures are bred, sort of like ant queens. I wonder if relocating a Mirelurk king would prompt the others to move. Some of these observations about their armor and camouflage gave me an idea for reinforced neutral-colored headgear. Consider it thanks for not interfering with them. Oh, speaking of which, take these, so you can continue to avoid them in the future. Correct as always. And your feedback's really led to a very smartly written book. Maybe too smart for some folks, I worry. Of course, if the reader can't be bothered to understand something important as a book on how to stay alive, then what can we do, huh? And in case those readers blame you for their ignorance, here's your payment. 2 big boxes of ammo. Now, on to the next chapter. The last chapter is a bit more esoteric. It's about the survival of humanity as a whole and how to rebuild society. Deep stuff, huh? We need to know how large settlements are formed, how to harness the old technology, and I'll need you to get ancient history from a nearby library. We're in the last stretch now, so let's finish it up strong. What's first? Don't be so sure. You'd be surprised how confused people get, even about important things. In this case, I'm talking about Rivet City. It's the most successful survivor settlement around, but no one here really knows how it started. Of course, that's why it's important to know how a place like that succeeded. So I need you to go there and do some researching. Oh, now I can't wait for what you find out down there. And check around to make sure you're hearing the real deal. Why, I'm flat. Oh, I haven't got nearly the experience in the wastes that you do. If I tried half of these things, I'd get my head blown off. At least you look like you can really handle yourself out there. All I'm good at is coming up with the ideas and fiddling with junk for caravans. I know, right? I figured instead of just helping out the caravans with odd junk, why not put my brilliant mind to work for everyone? And between my mind and your experience, this guide'll save a dozen times more lives than those greedy merchants will. That's the...
Here. You've done so much for us. I want you to have this. It's all I have to offer you. No, thank you.